Süßer, sieben Tage aus Marschieren. Next, I'd like to sing a couple of notations. So, F, E, A, Nano Kimidean, locally compact field of residue characteristic P. As in Collins' lectures, A0F is the set, is the union for any positive integer n of the set of isomorphism classes of cuspidal, irreducible, smooth, complex representation of G and F. And E of F will denote the set of n classes of simple characters of I remind you that you have a surjective map from A0F onto the set of n classes over F. So, given an irreducible cuspidal representation, you can associate with its n classes. We denote it theta pi, which is the n class of any simple character theta in the set C L theta psi F associated with a single stratum. The underclass of any simple character theta such that pi restricted to the compact open subgroup H1 of A theta contains has an irreducible component isomorphic to Z. And there is the following ramification theorem that gives you an arithmetic interpretation of the underclass of cuspidal representation due to So I will denote like this the local Langevin's correspondence from A0F to G0F, which is the union, which is the set of isomorphism classes of irreducible complex representation of the value group of F. We have fixed a separable closure of F defined by Q. And given pi and pi prime two irreducible complex representations not necessarily of the same degree, so not necessarily defined over the same group GL. These cuspidal representations have the same underclass if and only if n pi and n pi prime restricted to the wide inertia subgroup PF have a component in common. give an individual example. A Kerr-Friedel representation has depth 0 if and only if its associated Landau class is the null Landau class, and if and only if the Galois representation associated to pi is trivial on Y dimension. Now I will consider an inner form of GL. So let G be an inner form of GL and F for some positive L. So we have already seen this work in the former lectures. So G is of the form GLMD, where D is a division algebra of center F, of finite dimension over its center, is the square of a positive integer D, with the property that M times D is equal to L. And I will denote by A2 of G the set of the discrete series, of G, which is made of essentially square integral complex representations of G. So for these groups, the inner forms of GLN, for G, there is, as for GLN, there is a theory of single types, and of endoclasses. And there is also the Jacquet-Langlands correspondence between before the Jacquet-Langlands correspondence. So you have a theory of endoclasses for inner forms. So there is a map from A. So you can associate an endoclass to any Kerr-Friedel representation, but more generally to any discrete series representation. So you have a map from A to G to E of F. The endoclasses for GLN are the same as the endoclasses for inner forms. It is the same set of endoclasses. So you have a map. So since G is fixed, the map is not surjective. The image is made of the endoclasses of degree dividing N. So on the other hand, you have the local Jacquet-Langlands correspondence. Which is a bijection from A to G to A to G and F, which I will denote like this, the J L superscript. Which is characterized by A character identity, at elliptic regular conjugacy places. Oops. By a character identity of the form face JL pi is equal to a sign minus to be L minus L times the trace of pi at elliptic regular conjugacy classes. Can one describe explicitly the Jacquelin-Blanc correspondence in terms of the theory of types? And more, since I'm interested in endoclasses in this scope, there is a more the weaker following question. So, given a discrete series representation pi of G, compute the endoclasses associated with the Jacquelin-Blanc transfer of pi in terms of the endoclass of pi. And the conjecture is very simple. The Jacquelin-Blanc correspondence that should preserve endoclasses.
Thanks to
this assumption, the fact that L has been chosen to be different from B, as in the complex case, you have parabolic functors, you have there are functors I, PG, R, PG for any parabolic subgroup P of G. And thanks to this assumption, L different from P, these functors, exactly as in the complex case, are exact. They preserve finite length. They preserve finite type, and they preserve admissibility. And since L is different from P, the cardinality Q of the residue field of F is non-zero mod L. So you can take a square root, you can choose a square root, it is an arbitrary choice, but it can be made. And you can normalize, so Q is invertible in FL bar, so you can normalize parabolic induction and parabolic restriction. And as in the complex case, you have an adjunction property. Parabolic induction is right adjoint to parabolic restriction. As in the complex case, you can define cuspid representation, but an important, a crucial difference between complex representation and modular representation is the fact that there is a difference between cuspidal and supercuspidal. So the definition of cuspidal, as usual, is the following. So suppose pi is irreducible, an irreducible representation of P, so over FN bar. Pi is cuspidal if RGP of pi is zero for any proper parabolic sub. Same definition as in the complex case. Second definition, pi is supercuspidal if it is not. So the definition of cuspidal is equivalent to pi. Pi does not embed in proper parabolically induced representation. Supercuspidal means that pi is not a subquotient of any parabolic induction of the form IPG sigma for P, a proper parabolic subgroup with a Levy decomposition ML. And for sigma, irreducible in N. A priori, you have, in the definition of supercuspidal, a priori, you have to impose sigma to be irreducible if you want, when you want to prove the existence of the supercuspidal support for an irreducible representation. And it turns out that you don't need, actually, to assume sigma is irreducible in the definition, but it is a theorem that comes a posteriori. And which is related to the existence of projective envelopes for supercuspidal representations in the category of of course, thanks to the adjunction property of the parabolic functors, supercuspidal representation is always cuspidal, but the converse need not be true. I give you an example of a cuspidal representation that is not supercuspidal. Suppose that G is GN2F, and suppose that L divides Q plus 1. Q is the cardinality of the field of F. So if you prefer, Q is minus 1 mod L. And you look at the induced, the non-normalized induced, parabolically induced transformation. B is the Borel, the standard Borel of G. So this is a space of smooth functions on G. And this representation is smooth, and unlike the convex space, it has length 3. It has length 3 with components the trivial character, the unramified character given by the absolute value of the determinant, which has order, so since Q is minus 1 mod L, this character has order at most 2. And if you look at the Jacquet module of this representation, it has length 2, so one of these three components has to be cuspid. But there is another component, unlike the there is another component, I will denote it by rho, which is cuspid. And of course, it is not cuspid, since by definition it occurs in a parabolically induced representation. So given pi an irreducible representation of G with coefficients in Fn bar, there exists a cuspidal support, or there exists a unique up to conjugacy cuspidal support as in the convex case. But it turns out that the cuspidal support is not very interesting when you look at modular representation. What is more interesting is the super cuspidal support. It is not clear whether the super cuspidal support is unique up to conjugacy. So this, for GLN and inner form, this is given by the following theorem, due to Albert Hominger and myself. Any irreducible Fn bar representation of G has a unique supercuspidal support, so unique up to G conjugacy. So supercuspidal support means that the supercuspidal support of pi is a supercuspidal representation of a Levy such that pi occurs as a subquotient of the induced representation, the parabolic induced representation of this Levy. It is very tempting to conjecture that for any periodic regular group G, the super cuspidal support of an irreducible representation will be unique up to conjugacy. It is very tempting, but don't do that because it's false. There is a recent example in SP8F for L dividing Q squared plus 1. There is a cuspidal, a unipotent cuspidal representation of SP8, which has two non-conjugate supercuspidal supports. And it is already the case of so here F is periodic, but actually this counterexample comes from the finite SP8. It is already the case for SP8Q. So what can we do with supercuspidal support? We can take inertial classes of supercuspidal pairs, And we can ask whether there is a block decomposition of the category of modular representation. So the answer is yes, for inner form of GFN. The category RUP FN bar G, the category of most representations of G with coefficients in FN bar, has a block decomposition, and the blocks are in one-to-one correspondence with inertial classes of super cuspidal pairs. I started with complex representation. Now I interview you about modular representation. How can I go from complex representation to modular representation, or the other way around? Now we are going to consider an elliptic representation. So smooth representation of G over QM bar, a fixed algebraic closure of the field of elliptic numbers. Again, the definition of smooth is the same, it does not depend on the coefficient field. So why is it interesting to consider elliptic representations? Because in some cases of you can reduce model an elliptic representation, and it will give you a modular representation. So for a when the group is finite, it is always possible to do that. When the group G is not finite, so there is a notion of integrality. An irreducible representation by over QL bar of G is said to be integral if it has, in its underlying vector space, it has a G-stable Zn bar lattice. So, if pi is integral, make a choice of such G-stable Zn bar lattice, L, and then there is the following result due to Guimeras. First, if you tensor L by FL bar over ZL bar, you get a smooth representation which has finite length. It is a finite length, smooth FN bar representation of G, but this representation depends a priori on the choice of L. But second fact, the semi-simplification of this finite length representation does not depend on the choice of L, it only depends on pi. It's independent of the choice of L, and it is denoted RL of pi. RL as a reduction model. So RL of pi is semi-simple. It is a semi-simplification of this representation. You can think of it as being in the cross-elliptic group of finite length representations of G. I give you an example of reduction model. Same example, G is Gn2, and L divides Q plus 1, and consider the Steinberg representation, the usual Steinberg representation of G. Then it is integral. It is integral, and if you reduce it mod R, what do you get? So, here this is over QL bar. And if you reduce it mod R, what do you get? You get the character absolute value of the determinant plus the mod L cuspidal representation which appeared in the previous example. So in particular, you see that the reduction mod L of an irreducible representation need not be irreducible. Okay, so is it a very restrictive condition for a representation to be integral? Are there many integral representations or are there few integral representations? There is a very simple criterion of integrality on the supercuspidal support of the cuspidal support of the representation due to Mieras. A representation pi of G, irreducible over QL bar, is integral if and only if the cuspidal representations occurring in its cuspidal support have a central character. With integral values. And even if it appears as the bar types. So, in particular, in any Bernstein block, in particular, for any irreducible elliptic representation of G, there is a representation pi zero in the same Bernstein block, which is integral. And we have the following fact. So let pi be an elliptic irreducible representation of G, and let pi zero be as above, integral and in the same Bernstein block. Then what happens if you reduce pi zero mod L? Then all irreducible components of the reduction mod L of pi zero have the same supercuspidal supports up to inertia. So if you prefer, all of them belong to the same block of the category of mod L representations of G. And second, this block that I will denote BL of pi does not depend on the choice of pi zero. The integral representation that you have chosen in the same Bernstein block as pi. Okay. Now, I would like to introduce the notion of linked representation. And which will be an equivalent relation between irreducible representation. So now we go back to complex representation. But we still fix M different from B. So I introduced the following definition. Two representations pi and pi prime, so two irreducible complex representations of G are said to be L linked. Are L linked if are L linked if there exists an isomorphism of fields I between the field of complex numbers and QL bar exists such that if you look at I star pi and I star pi prime, the elliptic representations that come from pi and pi prime by formally replacing C by QL bar through this isomorphism of fields, such that they have the same associated block in the category of modal representation. Now remember that our goal is to say something about in the classes. So first remark. Any two L linked representations, discrete series representations of G have the same endomass. It is not difficult, it comes essentially from the definition of an underclass. The underclass of a representation comes from the restriction to this representation to a propy group. And since L is different from B, when you have a representation of a propy group and when you reduce it mod L, you do not lose information. So if two representations are L linked, they will have the same endomass. Okay, now, second definition. Two discrete series representations. Two discrete series representations, pi and pi prime, are. So I insist these are complex representations. Say that they are linked if there exists a finite family of prime numbers, L1, L2, LR, all of them being different from B, and if there exists a finite family of discrete series representations, so pi, the first one, pi 0, is pi, and then you have pi 1, pi 2, etc., and the last one, pi R, is pi prime, such that for all I, pi I minus 1 and pi I are Li linked. I should have said something in the previous definition, the definition of M-linked. This definition does not depend on the choice of the isomorphism of field. This definition is independent of I. If this is true for one I, one particular I, it will be true for any choice of I. So, as a consequence, the definition of being linked won't depend of any choice of isomorphism of fields between C and the QLI bar that you will do. Okay, and of course, two linked discrete series representations of G have the same underpass. Now it starts being interesting because the converse is true. You have the following characterization of for discrete series of representations for having the same underpass. Two discrete series of representations pi by prime of G are linked if and only if they have the same underpass. I forgot to say something. Maybe I said it, but I did not write it on the blackboard. In this definition, the finite family of representation pi I, I want them to be all of them discrete series representation. It is possible to have a more general definition of links, but here in this talk, I want to talk about discrete series representation only.
Cases where one L does not suffice? Are there cases where one L does not suffice?
Yes. Yes. Yes, for instance, very quickly, so if you can imagine, to give you a simple example, for simplicity, you can imagine that this makes sense also for representation of GLNFQ. So take a Cuspidal representation of GLNFQ, and how can you link it to the trivial character? The Cuspidal representation of GLNFQ corresponds through the Green's parameterization, or the Linusky parameterization, to a regular character of FQ to the N star. Basically, the prime numbers that will occur here will be the prime numbers dividing the order of this regular character. Okay, so now we have our reinterpretation of what it means for two discrete series of representation of G to have the same underclass, but what does it have to do with the Jacobian's correspondence? Okay, again, fix L different from B, and also fix an isomorphism of fields between C and QL bar. Then, so thanks to this isomorphism of field, I can, if I want to, replace formally C by QL bar in the Jacquet-Langlands correspondence, and I will get an elliptic Jacquet-Langlands correspondence, but which won't depend on the choice of the isomorphism. It simply comes from the fact that when you look at the identity of characters defining the Jacquet-Langlands correspondence, you have a sign, which is minus 1 to the n minus m, which will be fixed by any automorphism of it. Okay, so we have the following theorem. In two parts. So start with two discrete, complex discrete series representations of G. So first, replace C by QL bar by using this isomorphism of field, and assume pi prime are integral. Then their Jacquet-Langlands transfers will also be integral. Basically, because for discrete series representation, integrality can be detected just by looking at the central character of the discrete series representation. And since the Jacquet-Langlands correspondence preserves central characters, integrality will be preserved for discrete series representation. So then the Jacquet-Langlands transfers are integral, and pi is congruent to pi prime mod L. So what does it mean? It means that the reduction mod L of pi is equal to the reduction mod L of pi prime. Even only if the same holds for the Jacquet-Langlands transfer. So this is called the congruence property of the Jacquet-Langlands correspondence. The elliptic Jacquet-Langlands correspondence is compatible with taking congruences mod any prime number different from P. And so this is a very natural statement, but if we want to go back to our notion of linked representation, we need a slightly different statement by using our blocks BL. So it's the second part derives from the first one plus other additional properties. Second part, what is it? BL of pi is equal to. So here, no need to replace C by QL bar, and no need to assume that the representations are integral. Because the definition of BL does not require it. BL pi is equal to BL pi prime, even only if the same holds for the Jacquet-Langlands transfer of pi and pi prime. So, if you prefer, you can state it as follows. Pi and pi prime are N linked if and only if Jm pi and Jn pi prime are linked. And of course, since this holds for any prime number n different from p, you have the following corollary. Pi and pi prime are linked if and only if Jn pi and Jn pi prime are linked. And for two discrete series representations, being linked is equivalent to having the same underclass. So you have the second following corollary. Theta pi is equal to theta pi pi, if and only if theta jn pi is equal to theta jn pi pi. What does it tell you? It does not tell you that the Jacques-Lambert correspondence preserves underclasses. What it tells you is that if two discrete series representations have the same underclass, then the same holds for the Jacques-Lambert transfers. So you can put it as follows. You have the following. So A to G, here you have the Jacques-Lambert correspondence, to A to G and F. Here you have a map from A to G to E of F that associates to any discrete series representation in standard class. You have something similar on the GLNF side. And what this corollary tells you is that there exists a map, a unique map, between E of F and itself. That makes this diagram commutative. And now it remains to prove the conjecture of the interclass invariance conjecture. So it remains to prove that this unique map is the identity.
For pi to speed up
with cascade-like transfer. And so, why is it interesting to reduce to that specific class of that specific class of representation? Because if phi and its Jacquet-Langlands transfer JL by R cascadeable, so look at phi, you know that phi is given by a conjugacy class of extended maximal simple type, say J lambda. And there is, it is possible to express the trace of pi at specific elliptic, so for certain elliptic regular elements G in G, it is possible to express the trace of pi at G as a sum. I will not write explicitly the formula, as a sum of terms depending on the extended maximal simple type lambda. And since you have supposed, you have assumed that JL pi is also cascadeable, you can do something similar on the GLNF side by taking an extended maximal simple type for JL and pi, and you have two formulas for two explicit formulas in terms of simple types for the trace of pi and for the trace of JL pi at specific elliptic regular elements. And if you have such identities for enough elliptic regular elements, you will be able to translate translate in these terms in the Jacquet-Langlands correspondence. Conclusion. So this strategy has been elaborated by Bushnell and Enya, and when in the essentially time case, so when pi so when pi and J and pi are cuspidal and essentially time, with this strategy, they are able to prove that the endoclass is preserved by the Jacquet-Langlands correspondence. Following the same strategy and the same method, the general case of the endoclass invariance conjecture has been announced recently by André Adot. Thank you.
Questions?
A small question at the beginning of the talk. You gave an example, talk about an example in SP8 where we have not the mass of the support. Could you give more explanation of a finite field, for instance?
Can I give more explanation?
Yeah, to give to more precision of the example. What are the two?
I can be a little more precise. In SP4, you have theta 10. In SP4Q. So, in SP8Q, when L divides Q Q squared plus 1, and maybe you have to assume that L is large enough, maybe greater than 7, I don't remember, there exists a cuspidal representation type that occurs the parabolic induction of the trivial character of the minimal torus, minimal torus isomorphic to GN1 to the 4, and it also occurs in the parabolic induction the parabolic induction of theta 10 times 1 times 1 from the Levy SP4 times GN1 square. But I cannot give more detail. I cannot explain why this is the case. It is the case when you look at character tables or decomposition matrices of projective indecomposable modules. You can see.
Any further questions?
Was this lateness or to study for other groups, the other classical groups?
With Sean Stevens, we would like to study this linkness property for classical groups. Yes, but we have no result at all yet. So extend the definition of being linked and see whether there is a relation with endoclasses for classical groups.
Let's thank the speaker again.